All right. So, two things I wanted to try out today. One is my new WindRider bib and jacket here. Just got it yesterday. And it's in the low 50s today, about 51, 52 degrees right now. And I was just cruising down the river here. Water temperature's at about 56 degrees. And sure enough, the only thing that I felt cold was my hands. I didn't bring my gloves. And of course, anything that's exposed, my ears, my face. But so far, I'm impressed. All I have on underneath this is, and I did this on purpose because I'm going out to the ocean on Monday. So I wanted to see how to dress. I didn't want to overdress. Although it's a good idea to dress in layers. All I have on is a t-shirt. Just a t-shirt, and I got some gym shorts. Normally I would wear thermal, hoodie, long johns, whatever. And I'm super comfortable. It's very thin, it's very light. And again, it's keeping me warm. So when I go out to the ocean on Monday, I probably will go ahead and dress in layers. That's always a good idea because you can always take something off, right? But you can't put it on if you don't have it. But I'm loving this. I did not want to stop fishing. This winter. But being comfortable is going to be super important, right? And so staying dry is going to be huge, and blocking the wind, of course. I bought the black on purpose because I figured when the sun's shining like it is now, that's just going to add a little bit more warmth to the outfit. But yeah, these are the pants. I went ahead and got me some nice boots too. Waterproof boots, which was nice when I went to launch the boat. Now I can just step in the water like I do in the summertime. So far I'm super happy with this WindRider gear. I know there's a thicker version that you can use, I guess, if you're going like ice fishing and stuff. So I don't think I'm going to need that. I think if I dress in layers and just throw this bad boy on top, it's going to be great. It's true to size. I normally wear a large, so I'm glad I got the pants in a large. The jacket, I almost got an extra large, thinking when I dress in layers, I'm going to need that. But the jacket's a large, and it's perfect. It fits me perfect. I actually thought it was a little bit too big. But once I start putting hoodies and dressing in layers underneath this thing, I'm going to be glad that it is a little bit bigger. So I think it was worth the investment. I spent $230, $240, something like that, on this outfit. But I know I'm going to use it, and I'm going to use it well. So again, the key things that I was looking for was, one, waterproof. I have a center console boat, and you can get hypothermia without falling in the water, right? You take on a wave and it's 36, 35 degrees and you have to cruise back to the dock or whatever. That's risky. I feel confident with this thing. Take on a huge wave, the water's gonna roll right off. You're gonna stay dry underneath, which means you can stay warm, and you don't have to ruin a perfect day of fishing just because you take on a little bit of water, or if it starts to rain a little bit or something like that. So I love it. I love it. I'm super happy with this outfit. If you're thinking about getting one, just do it. I think it was worth every penny. The quality just feels great. I did, look at different reviews and stuff, and so obviously I haven't used it much myself yet, but I trust what I saw out there. So I just thought I would add another review myself to this WindRider. So the red one looked really cool, but again, I wanted the black because, like, even now I can feel the sun. It just, anything that's black on this outfit that it touches is extra warm that I'm getting. So all right, my friends, my name's Danny Falcone. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you like it, hit the like button. And if you want to subscribe, do it. And because I plan to be posting a lot of videos this winter, my plan is to dominate winter fishing this year. All right, I bought myself a nice little boat, and I plan to use it and use it well. And I'm not gonna let the weather stop me from fishing. Okay, so but obviously, be safe, be smart. As you can see, I got my life jacket on here. You know, when you're out on the water by yourself, you should have that. I got my ACR, my EPIRB in my pocket here. So just, you know, taking all the steps to make sure that I'm being as safe as possible when out in the water. Safety first, and then it's time to have some fun. So the next thing I'm gonna be testing out is, I got myself for my bass boat, I got the Minn Kota Co-Pilot. So I'm getting ready to test that out now. Probably gonna do a little bit of fishing, see if I get lucky with a bass or two. Let me tell you, I got the Minn Kota Riptide Tarova 80 pound thrust saltwater 54 inch shaft for my Key West Center console boat, and I love it. It's like having my own private captain. That thing was magnificent. So I'm super excited to go to the Indian River Inlet this Monday and dominate the inlet, okay? It's about dominating the weather, the inlet, the water, the current, all that stuff. Be smart, but thanks to technology, we got tools out here that can just make it super fun. So we'll see how this co-pilot does here today. I got a feeling it's gonna be great, all right? So I'll be posting a video on that. Thanks for watching, my friends. Danny Falcone, out.